Long time ago, there was a king and his son who lived in a palace. His son was short and arrogant, but the king was really honey with his son. However, the king always be patient with his son's attitude. One day, his son went to the forest, and suddenly, he went out of the palace. There are two bodyguards which always guard him.
I'm sorry, Prince. Where are you going?
Don't disturb me. I want to go somewhere by myself.
But my...
Don't follow me.
Prince! Prince! Prince!
And the prince left the palace, and he went to the forest to hunt. Suddenly, a wood fairy appeared.
You heartless human! These animals are not your toys. They are living things that God has created. This is a wonderful nature, and you are destroying it. Have they ever hurt you?
How dare you talk to me like this? Don't you know who am I? I'm a prince of this kingdom, and this forest belongs to me. Every tree, animal, and even this land belongs to me.
Ignore him, prince. Natures belong to God, the creator of this universe. Not you. You don't have any rights to kill innocent animals.
Stop, lady. I want to kill animals.
The fairy got mad, and the prince got scared seeing her.
You arrogant human! I curse you to be a tiny frog. Now, snakes of this forest will hunt you down, like you hunt the poor sheep for your meal.
Immediately, the prince transformed into a frog.
Oh, what did you do to me? I beg you, wood fairy, please forgive me. I promise I will never harm Mother Nature again. I will be kind to every creature. I promise, please forgive me.
I think you have realized your mistakes. But your attitude shall not go unpunished. I will give you a counterspell.
Yes, please, my lady. I swear I will be a better man.
You must find a princess who disrespects the poor creatures and convince her to be kind to you. If you succeed to change a human's nature, only then you will become a prince again.
Across the river, there is a palace. In the palace, are live a king with his pretty daughter. She was so beautiful and loving that the king always gave her everything.
Daddy, I'm bored of playing with my old toys. I want something new to play.
Oh my dear, since you are so lovely, I will give you the most precious toy.
The king opened his golden cupboard and took a shining golden ball.
Wow, amazing!
Take this ball. It will shine as bright as the sun under the sky. But this is very precious. Don't lose it.
Thank you, father. You are the best father in the world.
One day, the princess went to the garden to play with a golden ball.
Pardon, princess, may we accompany you to play in the garden?
No, I can go by myself. Just stay at the palace.
Okay, princess, we will stay here.
When the princess played a golden ball, suddenly the golden ball fell into the well. And the princess was surprised.
Oh my god, how can I take it?
What's wrong, princess?
The princess heard the voice and saw an ugly frog. She was surprised. Hey, an ugly frog. What are you doing in here?
I just want to help you.
Seriously?
Yes, in one condition.
Whatever you like, frog. My clothes, pearls, and jewels, or even the crown that I wear.
No, I don't want it all. But I want to be your friend. If you would promise me all this, I will dive into the water.
Okay, please take it now.
A minute later, the frog emerges from the well and brings the golden ball.
Hey, princess, this is your golden ball. Remember you promised me? Please don't break your promise.
Okay, I won't.
The next day, when the princess was sitting on the dining table with the king, eating from a golden plate, she heard something outside.
Oh, princess, let me in!
The princess got up and ran to see who outside the palace, but when she looked, there was an ugly frog.
You dirty creature! How dare you come to my palace?
She went back hastily to her seat. Feeling uneasy, the king noticed how restless she was.
My child, what are you afraid of? Did you see a giant?
Oh, no, daddy. There is an ugly frog.
And what does the frog want?
Oh, daddy, when I was sitting by the well, and I'm playing with my golden ball, it fell into the water and the frog came and got it back from me on a condition that I would let him be my companion, and I promised him, but I never thought he could leave the water and come here. Now he is outside and he wants to come in.
Your Highness, please let me in. Your doctor promised me something.
Dear, once you make a promise, don't break it.
So she let him in, and the frog followed her until she got back to her seat. They were eating together until he was full. Then the princess went out of the dining room, and the frog followed her.
What do you want from me, ugly frog?
I just want you to keep your promise.
Feeling annoyed, the princess pushed the frog. He found it. And princess was shocked.
Oh my god, what's wrong? I didn't mean to hurt you. Please wake up.
The princess poked him with her finger, but he was dead as stone. She was confused, and she softly kissed the frog. With all the wonders, the frog opened his eyes and turned into a prince.
Where is the frog?
Don't worry, princess. I'm the same frog. When I was hunting at the forest, suddenly a wood fairy appeared. She got mad at me because I killed animals to my heart's content.
The princess felt ashamed of being so unkind.
Don't be sad, beautiful princess. Now promise me you will treat anyone kindly.
Yes, I will, prince.
That's great. Since you have decided to be a kind woman, can I ask you something?
Of course. Anything, prince.
You are the most beautiful girl I have met, and I'm in love with you. Will you marry me?
Without a hesitation, the beautiful princess said yes to the charming prince.
In a perfect storybook, the world is brave and good. Hero takes your hand, a sweet love will follow. But life's a different game, and the sorrow and the pain, only you can change your world.
tomorrow.
With her father's consent, they got married. Every day, the couple feed animals and took the utmost care of the nature's creativity.
Well done, my children. You have proved yourselves to be kind human beings. Who treat this nature better, God will always shower His blessing upon you.
Thereafter, the couple lived happily and blessed forever.
And wear your own crown.